the temperature right now outside, it's about 28, 32 degrees. Underneath the house is currently at 53.
Wow. Did you know homes built on crawl spaces are typically colder than homes built over basements and slabs? Most crawl spaces today are vented, which means they're at the mercy of the stack effect, which allows a lot of cold air to go into the vented crawl space as well as make its way into the living space. And according to EnergyStar.gov, a properly sealed, moisture-protected, and insulated crawl space will increase comfort, save on energy costs, improve the durability of the home, and reduce moisture into the home as well as pests. So today I'll be sharing 5 products and methods to make sure your crawl space is warmer in the winter and stays cooler in the summer. But make sure you stay to the end of the video because I'm going to share a bonus tip about subfloor insulation, whether I recommend it or not, as well as one of the most overlooked places to air seal in your crawl space. Whenever Crawl Space Ninja goes into a home to address whatever moisture or mold problems there is, one of the first things we need to do is remove the subfloor insulation, which exposes all of the area of the floor above so that we can air seal that subfloor. So that is my very first tip, is I recommend you air seal the subfloor of the crawl space. What this is going to do is it's going to reduce the stack effect and keep the air in the crawl space separate from the air in the living space. For example, if you're sitting around watching TV or trying to enjoy time with your family and your home feels drafty, this is primarily because the crawl space air is able to make its way into the home. As soon as your heat kicks on, that air transfers from the crawl space directly into the living space, which leads me to the second place you should always insulate, which is the rim joist insulation. Rim joist insulation, according to buildingscience.com, is considered a critical seal number 2 to attic air sealing. So make sure if you're going to air seal the subfloor of the crawl space, you want to air seal the rim joist of the crawl space as well. We do this with a combination of foam board and spray foam. Now, Crawl Space Ninja typically does crawl space encapsulation. So the other place we're going to air seal is the vents of the crawl space. If you have a vented crawl space, you want to make sure you use a combination of foam board and spray foam to air seal around those vents. This will help keep that really cold air from getting into the crawl space, which could cause frozen pipes and bursting pipes in the future. Another place to make sure you air seal and insulate is the door of the crawl space. Most homes that we service have exterior doors, and we want to make sure we put R10 foam board on the inside of that exterior door and use weather stripping to air seal as much of that door as possible. If for some reason you access the crawl space from the living space, you should air seal that door as well. Now let's get into the foundation wall. Most people don't realize that according to energy.gov, which is the Department of Energy website, it's actually better to insulate the foundation wall of a crawl space than it is to insulate the subfloor of the crawl space, because you're creating a thermal break at the foundation wall. Now keep in mind, if you're building a home today, you can insulate the exterior of the foundation wall as part of this process versus the interior. But most of the crawl spaces that we deal with are retrofit crawl spaces that we have to repair or replace insulation due to moisture problems inside the crawl space. So for Crawl Space Ninja, we find it is better to insulate the interior of the foundation wall. A lot of companies will use foam board, but we use what's called the insulation vapor barrier. This is a better process because we're able to both insulate the foundation wall as well as protect the crawl space from moisture that is coming through the foundation wall and control humidity better with the insulation vapor barrier. This is one that's often overlooked. You want to make sure you air seal the ductwork in the crawl space. The worst thing you can do is have air from the crawl space, getting access to the ductwork, and then going directly into your living space. According to energy.gov, ductwork can leak anywhere between 15 to 30%, with an average of 25% leakage. That means that whatever air is in the crawl space is making its way up to the living space, and either your HVAC system has to condition that air through the ventilation system, or it's causing indoor air quality issues because you're pulling dusty crawl space air directly into the living space without it being filtered prior to going through the HVAC system. Now for that bonus tip, do I recommend subfloor insulation? I don't recommend you remove subfloor insulation if it is already there, if you don't have a moisture or mold problem. But as I mentioned before, most of the time, Crawl Space Ninja deals with moisture and mold issues in which we have to remove the subfloor insulation in order to address that moisture and mold problem properly. But if you currently have subfloor insulation, I would recommend you leave it in place and pull it aside and air seal behind it if you're able to do so. Now let's talk about that most overlooked place that you want to air seal. And be careful with this because your pest control company may advise you not to do this. But where the sill plate of the home touches the foundation wall of the crawl space, usually that is a great place for air to move from the outside in or from the inside out. So if you'll use a bead of caulk or a small bead of spray foam all the way around the inside perimeter of that sill plate where the pressure-treated wood is touching that block or foundation wall, you want to make sure you air seal that. But newer homes built today may already have some type of sealant between the rim joist and the foundation wall. If you're a DIYer and want to tackle this project yourself, we've got everything you need to do so on the diy.crawlspaceninja.com website, which includes the insulation vapor barrier and all the spray foam and even foam board to seal those crawl space vents. And of course, pick up the Ninja Dry Pro dehumidifier while you're there as well. I'm Michael Church with Crawl Space Ninja, and I hope you make it a happy and blessed day, and we'll see you later.